In this video, we will define the electric current and talk about the so-called continuity equation. Let's assume we have some kind of charge distribution rho, which depends on the position r. If we sum up all contributions from rho, we get the total charge q. Now, if this charge distribution travels with a velocity v, we get the electric current density j. This current density has dimensions of coulombs divided by square meters and seconds. The flux through some area A is called current strength, or electrical current. Here, df is a tiny area element pointing outwards of some volume. If we check the dimensions, I has coulombs over seconds, which is the usual amp. Now let's talk about the continuity equation. This equation connects the charge density rho and the current density j. We start with the conservation law for electrical charges. If we take a charge q in some volume v, the only way that q can change is by flowing through the surface of v. Mathematically, the time derivative of q, which is the integral over the time derivative of rho over the volume v, is equal to minus the surface integral over the boundary of v of the current density. Let's stop for a moment and consider the minus sign. Remember that df points outwards of the volume. Now, if q decreases, the value on the left-hand side of the equation is negative. And if q decreases, this must mean that the current density flows out of the volume. This means j and df are parallel, that is, a positive quantity. Therefore, we need the minus sign to also have a negative number on the right. Using Gauss's theorem, which turns the surface integral into a volume integral over the divergence of j, we get this expression. Since our discussion should be independent of the volume, we can pick out these two terms and get the continuity equation. And that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching.